Hello and thanks for joining us today. This is a small steel construction that was created using the Inventor frame generator. However, it can also be a 3D model from any other source. It doesn't matter, as long as it contains geometries that look like steel profiles, and of course the file must be openable by Inventor. Now we want to do the steel detailing on this model, meaning that we want to add all the connections, such as end plates, frame corners, bolted connections, etc. And also automate subsequent processes such as bills of materials. This is not possible with the frame generator, but it is no problem with SolidSteel parametric. To use this frame generator model in SolidSteel, we convert the existing profiles to SolidSteel parts. This is very easy with the beam converter. In selection mode, we use the assembly option and click on any component to select all of them. We don't need the reference skeleton, so we uncheck it and click Analyze. This will take a short moment. Here on the next page we can see that there are no entries at the top under undetected components, so we can click on preview directly. Here is another overview of all parts, and we could use the functions on the right side of the dialog to make edits such as offsets or rotations, but this is not necessary here. Clicking build completes the conversion. In the feature tree, we have the frame generator parts at the top, which we hide with Alt plus V. Below that are our SolidSteel parametric parts and also the automatically generated sketch, which is of course underdefined. The sketch lines are now exactly where the profiles are and are not connected. This is not critical as long as we want to detail exactly this construction. If you want to make parametric changes, you simply have to adjust the sketch accordingly. Preparation is done. Let's start with the frame corners. I am using a pre-made custom connection for this. We have shown how easy it is to create custom connections yourself in another video. The link is in the description. We select cross beam and end beam and get a list of all the connections that fit this situation. We select the frame corner, get a preview, and also activate AI connection. AI connection automatically finds the three other identical installation situations, and by clicking on execute, four frame corners are inserted at once. Short waiting time while beams are cut to size and the connections are inserted with all the details such as ribs, bolts, etc. Finished. Okay, let's continue with the double end plate connections. As before, we have selected the cross and end beams, and now we have selected the prepared custom connection from the list. Enable AI connection and the software will find more matching installation situations. The capabilities of the AI filter can now be clearly seen. The beams selected now have the same profile as the ones just selected for the frame corner, and a horizontal beam has also been connected to a vertical beam. However, the rotation of the column was also taken into account, and the positions were correctly identified. We can confirm this and the four double end plate connections are inserted. We continue with the stage beams and the prepared double clip angle connections. Again with the AI connection option, of course, as we are familiar with it by now. All the right places were found correctly. Looks good, we can confirm. Nice, we're almost done with our steel detailing. All that's missing are the gussets for the bracing. I haven't created a custom connection for this yet, so we can take a quick look at it. But as mentioned, the link to the detailed video on this topic is in the description. We open the gusset dialog, select the source face and target face, and get a preview. This looks quite good. But of course we only need one row for the screws and can make other settings. Clicking on assemble opens the part selection where we can now define the bolt assembly. Default mountings adds two washers and a nut. The grip length is calculated automatically. I'm going to add a 10mm chamfer so that the plate has no sharp corners. The joint is now fully defined and we can add it by clicking on the execute button. Unfortunately, the button is now outside of the screen capture. At the moment, connection yes but custom connection no. So we open the Learn Custom Connection dialog and select cross and end beam again. We get a list with all connections involved in the beams. Of course, we select the gusset connection, assign a name, and can save the new connection in the custom connections database. The further way is now as usual via custom connections with the AI connections option, but I've shortened this in the video so it doesn't get too long. So here is our fully detailed steel frame. But this is by no means the end of SolidSteel parametric's capabilities. The follow-up processes are also part of the software. For example, We can now automatically assign part numbers according to our own criteria in BOM management by clicking refresh, and then generate bills of materials or start DXF exports. If you would like to see all this in more detail, including BOM export, click on the video suggested here. Otherwise, thanks for watching and see you next time. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel.